Welcome to 7 Days to Die, Romero Mod. This is another mod by Khaines in which zombies only take full damage with headshots. Some of the zombie behavior has slightly changed, and another main big difference is there is no horde knight. Horde knights have been disabled, but instead you have huge roaming horde, consistent roaming horde. I believe they start on day 2 at midnight with 30 zombies in a roaming horde that comes for you, and then every 6 hours after that. I don't know if they increase in size or not, but we're gonna have a first look at it, and I'm very excited to play it. So let's get started. I hope you guys are gonna have a good time. We're gonna be using the King Gen generated map that we use on our supporter server, which is loads of scattered villages and towns around the map, but mainly big flat green map with a huge city along the center of the map, which is kind of a take on the good old Hope City, if you remember that back in the older alphas. So looking at the default settings here, you can see that Adventurer is the default difficulty. We're gonna set that to Warrior. We have Bloodmoon disabled. You can't actually enable it. It's completely disabled. You can't enable it. You also have Zombie Night Speed Walk, which you can't change, and Zombie Feral Speed Walk. So it's kind of where you think, hey, we're okay. They're walking. We don't have to worry about a thing. But then you have these huge amount of zombies that already are in the world, which are just scattered around. But then on top of that, you have these huge roaming hordes. Max zombies, we're going to set that to 100 for now. Then we have 50 animals at any one time. That should be plenty. Sadly, that also includes, as far as I know, wolves and bears, which is obviously the downside, but it also means loads of food around. The actual amount of experience needed per level has been increased, as far as I understand, because there's so many zombies, just to make sure that you don't level up too fast. So we leave it at 100% and see how it goes. In the advanced section, everything will leave at default, except they would do mark airdrops on, because I always forget where they are otherwise. And welcome to a new world. Here we go, a fresh start that we love so much. Now, some of the changes that have been made is that we have the clock set to 4 o'clock when we start. I also marked the 00 location here on Hope City, which is where we are going to before we actually start the quest, because we want to be near the city, we want to be near the trader in the city, and we want to take the quest there, because the city is literally where we get the best loot. So if we want to live anywhere with a load of zombies, it's probably Hope City. Another thing that I've done is I have added some quality of life mods. So quality of life mods that have been added are bigger stacks and faster vehicles from Donovan mods. And that's pretty much it. And oh yeah, the loot lock as well, that we can lock ourselves a couple of fields. But everything else is by default, which is similar to Darkness Falls. I did add a modlet to leave the trader open 24/7, but I think that's already by default, because I think Romero mod uses the same logic as Darkness Falls, where it has the trader always open, and you can actually kill the trader, and the trader hub thing can actually be destroyed as well. So you have to be careful about that, especially with roaming hordes of that size. Living in the trader will probably kill the trader. And again, headshots is all that matters. This health bar is coming from the mod. So if I do a body shot... Oh, if I do a body shot? It's actually only 1 damage. You can see that there. 1 damage. But if I go for the face, it's the full 10 damage of my fists. So there you go. We already have a good start. But again, because they're walking... And what is the burn damage, actually? Oh, they only get 1 damage at a time as well. Okay, we're not going to be able to fight them, so we're just gonna run off for now. And here we have the slidey chicken, which is a rare species of slippery chick that you can only find in the deep north of this map. Another change actually the mod does on zombie behavior is, I hope that bear's not hunting me. No, it's that's his arse. He's not hunting me backwards. It's not that bad yet. Is that the zombies don't get that aggression mod. So as you fight them, they don't all of a sudden get that speed boost where they launch for you. Like, so that has been disabled. Also, I think zombie cops do not longer spit. And the vultures, the radiated vultures also don't spit. So you still have obviously the whole... difficulty with the zombies is that the sheer number is what is gonna overrun you in the end. Oh, look at this. E for pickup. Yes, we have this in this mod as well, which is absolutely fantastic, just like in Darkness Falls, which is great for farmers. You all know it, you have these big farms, and the one thing you always hate doing is reseeding everything. Which you don't have to do here, because if once you pick up the stuff that's grown, unlike the wild stuff, it actually leaves the seed behind, so you just pop. It grows again, and that's it, and you just keep picking up your harvest. This is a lovely little POI. It actually has loads of plants around it. Also, obviously, water that you can fill up your jars. But you get all sorts of plants, including aloe vera and yucca, which is great for making yucca juice in the beginning, which is really, really good. One of the things you probably notice as well is there. Oh, ho, ho, single headshot, exploding foreface, and some loot. Yeah, baby, that is my favorite. That was some random lucky crit there, because we don't do that much damage at all. Anyway, the combo pack is not included in this. This map was generated a little bit earlier for the server, where we weren't sure if playing with 20 people online on an 8K map at the same time, and combo pack is gonna perform well. So hence, vanilla buildings only. But it should be interesting enough. This is a first look, and if we have a good time, we could literally throw together a combination where it's Romero mod plus this mod plus that modlet, because I believe Romero mod is kept pretty vanilla in a lot of ways. So the changes are done only to the zombies. It doesn't really impact a lot more than the Bloodmoon settings and the zombie damage settings, like that you do only one damage on body shots and so on. So it should be compatible with a lot of mods, theoretically. We might come up with a nice mix. Anyway, we'll see how this does first and if you guys are interested, and then we can play more of this, of course. We made it to the center. Huge coal note here, actually, by the way, times three. Very, very lucky. Also, the city is big. So we're in the residential area here, I believe. We have industrial district, commercial district. I'm not really sure exactly about the layout, but I'm gonna link the map below in a pinned comment so you can actually see it. It's a huge city. We have a couple of desert spots here with some lakes, which is really nice. So we're gonna find a nice spot to build a base. And base building should be interesting in this mod, because there's no horde, but you have continuously roaming hordes that come for you. So you need to kind of have something like a horde base, but you can go outside and fight them as well, which should be easier. So you have a little bit of flexibility, but also at the same time, a little bit more difficulty because of the sheer number of zombies. So anyway, we're going to finish our quests. We're gonna place the wooden frames and, oh, don't touch me. And we're going to place the campfire, and I think then we should get the trader triggered. There we go, beautiful. Make the campfire. Do that all before we get eaten alive. Oh, my dear Lord, there she is. She's trying to do the grabbies. Don't do the grabbies. Here we go. Beautiful. And that is it. Locate the trader 600 meters this way. So sorry, guys. Can't stay for the party. I will be moving on. Oh, back. What do we have here? Oh, yes. We already found some amor. Very nice. There we go. Look at that. Beautiful. Oh, look at that. Nice car loot. What is this? Lanterns. You can't work if you can't see. Learn how to craft lanterns, mining huts, and helmet light mods. Nice. Lanterns are a really cool source of light, and I don't even think they need electricity wired up, which is absolutely fantastical. So we're nearly at the trader. So the aim for today is to obviously get to the trader. Also spend our first 4 points. Now, what I would like to do with my first 4 points, and it's just my recent preference, is one in Daring Adventurer for better loot rewards, or for more choices. Straight away, one into Master Chef to unlock the bacon and egg recipe and all the teas. One into Miner 69er straight away for unlocking the second tier tools. But also in this mod, you unlock all scrap iron tools. Because there's another layer between iron and wood or stone, which is great. So now you have all the scrap iron arrows. They actually unlock by default. You don't need to spend points in that. But if you have a pickaxe, for example, you now have a scrap iron pickaxe unlocked, which is great. So as soon as you start getting enough iron, you can already get the next tier of tools, which is brilliant. And then we have 1 point left that I usually like to put into Sexysaurus. Now, the choice there is either Sexysaurus for me, or depending how I feel, Healing Factory. But I think in this case, I'm gonna go with Sexysaurus, and the next couple of points I earn, I will decide what weapon kind of I want to focus on. I think I want to try Brawler and Machine Gunner, because I think it would be very interesting now with slow zombies to actually go full fist on in their faces, get really close up close and personal, and then have the, I think, assault rifles, AK-47. I don't know my guns. I don't know if the AK-47 falls under Machine Gunner, assault rifle, or if it falls under rifles. I think rifles are the one-shots and the sniper rifles, and then assault rifle would be AK-47, I think. So I'm gonna go with that. I think you also have scrap pistols, if I'm not mistaken, or they're called pipe pistols. You have a pipe pistol and a pipe rifle, which you can make straight off the bat, which is also a very good choice right away. Even though if you're going into Machine Gunner, you know, starting with a rifle is great. Oh, look at that, scrap iron pickaxe, lovely. So let's see what we have here on the trader. Nice, let's pick up all the coffee, very lovely. and we don't have any money yet. Let's see if we have a working forge. Yes! Oh, this is beautiful. We straight away can use this to start smelting some iron. There we go. Let's actually do that. Beautiful. And while we're here, why don't we actually also make a shovel quickly and start putting in some clay into that as well. And that way we can straight away start making forged iron, which is going to be amazing. We want to keep some of the iron for iron tools and all that. But yeah, this is pretty amazing. Let's see if we have anything else working. A cement mixer, that's not working. We got some sand, not working. Oh yes, we got the workbench recipe, which is absolutely fantastic. Also, if we have a wrench, we can wrench all this down because the trader is fully destructible or upgradable as well, if that's what you want to do. Now, you have to be careful, of course, if you're in the trade and you have these, oh, what a beauty, and you have these massive hordes coming for you, or roaming hordes, they will pound on the base. They will destroy this trader. Now, the trader itself, I think, has something like 100,000 health points, but if you have, like, 100 zombies pounding on you, you know, you're not going to last that long either. So we have to probably actively defend that trader if we ever get into that situation. Oh, look at that. Beautiful. No damage until he shows me his face. Oh, bookshelf is not lootable. All right, let's see what you got. Do you have any jobs? Oh, nice. Buried supplies. I take it. We need the clay anyway. And it's the same as always. He's surrounded by about 400 buildings that are in less than 500 meters near him. But he decides to give you jobs, which are way out. I suppose that's why he gives them to you in a way. Because it's like, well, I can get the buildings sorted myself here nearby. I can't go all the way out there because I can't leave my spot here. Anyway, maybe I see your inventory. We're going to keep the wheel. We don't have anything to sell yet to him. But we have a look and see what he got. Do you have an... Oh, he has a pistol actually for 400. Oh, look at those guys. They're already beautifully lined up. Oh, we got a drop there. Nice, we got some money. That means we can sell that straight away to Uncle Charlie over there, and we can get ourselves the pistol already. That is really, really good. A crappy pistol is better than no weapon at all. Yeah, selling that money comes in at 544. Really good. Do you have any resources? Do you have any iron? Oh, very good. You have actually loads of iron and comes in at 420. That is very good, I think, in the beginning, because that will allow us to make some...
Thanks for shopping here.
Weapons, so we can make the actual pipe rifle and pipe pistol, because we have duct tape. So now we just have to find a place where we're going to settle down first to hold up for looting. And then we're going to see if we want to convert a POI or if we build our own. We probably want to build our own base. There's a lot of free space here. I mean, if you look here, you have... loads of free space here. There's, I think, a huge amount of space here on that side, but we might want to be near a lake or something so we can refill. That would be really handy as well. Oh, what do we have here? We are right here beside the trader. And this is one of my favorite POIs, actually, on the bigger scale POIs that actually can work to be defendable. So what we're going to do is we're going to jump in here. We're going to let the zombies come to us. That's absolutely no problem. Let's get up there and pick up our climbing stuff. There we go. They're going to hit eventually through it, which is fine. And whatever way they come is okay. But here, we can actually make our way up and we can close everything else off. So this is not a bad spot because you can actually hide up there and they have to come in a certain way where you don't have to worry about. They can come from all directions. It doesn't matter because this is where they have to come through that door in the end. There's no choice. So we're going to take all this here off with our scrap axe and then we're going to put a ladder here. Actually, we're going to put the ladder there, I think. Yeah, let's take off this, put a ladder there, and that way we can... Oh, we can get up there and we don't have to worry about a thing. Let's do that quickly though. You can already hear them. Oh, whoa, 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 whoa. Okay, ladder. I think we only need one piece actually of the ladder. There we go. There we go. Nice. Okay, so now what we do is this door here, we open up. And we're going to put our block in front of it. And then that way the zombies can come from any direction. It doesn't matter at all. You see, there's already one. Let's put the half block down. Hopefully we get it down on time. Advanced. Oh, crap. Half block. There we go. There, nice. Oh, hello there. And we're going to upgrade that. Oh, there we go. Okay, good. And now we already have a defensible spot. Okay, it's already getting very hectic. There we go. Oh, I love the head explosions. So let's keep the energy. Every now and then do a little right swing, then let the energy come right back up. There we go. Boom. This is actually not too bad. I mean, again, you feel very confident because you're like, yeah, look at that. We have it under control. Oh, where is he going? There he is. He changed his mind. He's back. There we go. Very nice. All right. And we can now make our first knuckle wraps. The chairs in there, just pick them up and scrap them. They give you 6 leather each. So let's make ourselves the knuckle wraps. And as soon as we have another point. Oh, we actually have a point. So let's stop this. And let's put it into what we actually want to do, which is the brawler. Boom. And now we can even make a level 2. It's beautiful. Hey, sorry, lady. You can't just come in here and destroy all my stuff. Let's actually see how well we do with the knuckle wraps. Oh, wow. Knocked us straight on our ass. 55. How are we doing with actually right-click damage? Okay. Basically 25 per right-click, and as we level it up, it will just get worse and worse. But the good thing is, I think knuckle wraps like that work with beer, because I think beer is only with melee damage, so you can't use any melee weapons. It's not melee damage as in with clubs. I think it only works with fist weapons. And we can get basically drunk off our ass and have a lot of fun. All right, it took me a while to get set up. Oh, I thought I saw a bear there. That was just a pipe. To get set up, but we finally have managed to get ourselves sorted. We are making some yucca juice in a second, but let's go and have a rumble going on at night in our base. The land claim block is placed. I'm not sure why these guys are here, but hey ho, let's do it. There we go, nice. Okay, we're only going for the face. I can see already how this is gonna become very, very tricky. I'm like, okay, they're only walking, so it's, oh yes, so it's not a big whoop, but when you get loads of these guys, look at that. That is intense. Okay, at least we're gonna get some night action, I suppose. So as long as we can keep in front of them. There we go. Oh, this guy is gonna be a tough one. Oh, whoa, 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 whoa. Oh, not a spider zombie. He is a pain in the balls. Okay, why don't we go up here, jump here up quickly, and make some more arrows, because otherwise this is gonna end up really, really bad. So I actually tried to hold off to make some more scrap arrows, but I think the time has come for us to actually make loads and loads and loads more normal arrows. Where did I put my arrow machines? Here we go. We put all our feathers here. So let's go and make... Wow, we have no wood. Okay, we need to go and get wood. Okay, let's actually go. There's so many of them. Oh my god, we need wood. We need to get out of here somehow and get some wood. So let's actually let them pound away on this. There we go. And let them come back out to us. Let's get some wood, some trees, and then we can take them on. Wow. We might actually get lucky. I think trees still have fall damage. So we might be able to actually have the zombies get crushed by a tree. That would be pretty amazing. This is looking very good. We have a Congo line of zombies. Holy crap, this mod is gonna be hardcore. Okay, so let's see if we can get those guys here lined up. Come on, tree. Don't forsake me now. Did it kill any of them? No, it didn't. Did it cause any damage at all? No, it didn't. Oh, my balls. Okay, let's go.
Thank you.
All right, I think we are done for this episode. Holy crap, Apple. This took forever. I could have done a lot of things last night, but I think this is just what we got stuck with. This is it for now. There's a few more stranglers, but we're going to deal with them separately. Holy balls, that was insane. We're going to leave this here. We slightly run an hour and a half over time, but we're going to start the questing tomorrow. This was a lot of fun. I can see myself with a lot of beer and knuckle rubs just going full on ham on this and having a great time. Anyway, I hope you guys had a great time with the episode. If you did, remember to kick that like button in the balls, and I hope I see you guys in the next video. And if you're new to the channel and you like what you see, hit that subscribe button, and I'll see you guys next time. Until then, as always, viel Spaß and happy gaming.